Okay, we believe that the key for reducing emissions in aviation is technology. We're working on three different dimensions. Technology oriented. The first one is developing and deliver more efficient aircraft like the 787 and the 747-8, which will be delivered already this year. And they will bring respectively a 20% and 60% fuel efficiency improvement in the marketplace. The second area is getting more operational efficiency, which comes with modernized ATM, air traffic management systems like the CESAR and Single European Sky in Europe and NextGen in the US. And the third one, arguably, is the most important. It's not about reducing the fuel, but it's about changing the fuel. We're talking about sustainable aviation biofuels, which is a technology solution that will allow aviation to reach the target goals that we have defined for as an industry strategy for 2020-2050. Aviation biofuels, well, they have to be sustainable, first of all. This is very important for us. We are committed to strong sustainability standards for these aviation biofuels, in the sense they shouldn't compete with food, with water, and with land. This is the first thing. The way they reduce emission is basically on the entire life cycle, in the sense that in the growth phase, this feedstock will absorb CO2. So, they will release CO2 in the atmosphere later on, but then, considering the entire life cycle, there will be a significant reduction in the CO2 emission in the order of 70-80% on average, and maybe more if you can get improvements in the way this feedstock can grow, it can be processed and refined.
Well, in terms of fuels, the drop-in, what's very important for these new biomass type of fuels, they must be drop-in, and that means that they have to be compatible with the same fuel delivery system and the components of the aircraft. They can't be any different. The engine can't perceive them any differently. It has to produce the same power. They can't be more corrosive. They can't be any of those things. So true drop-in fuel effectively burns exactly the same as the old hydrocarbon fuel that it's replacing. They do, in fact, have carbon emissions, but in some cases they're lower. They burn more efficiently, but most important, they're replaceable and sustainable. They're not coming from oil. They're coming from other products. I watched kerosene being made from algae, which is a wonderful breakthrough. It was pretty exciting to see.